हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रोड टू आईआईटी। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सम टॉपिक्स ऑफ फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स। सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज स्ट्रीमलाइन फ्लो। सो वी आर गोइंग टू हैव बेसिक डेफिनेशंस टुडे। सो व्हाट इज स्ट्रीमलाइन फ्लो? स्ट्रीमलाइन फ्लो इज दैट फ्लो इन विच ईच एलिमेंट ऑफ लिक्विड पासिंग थ्रू अ पॉइंट ट्रैवल अलॉन्ग the same path with the same velocity as the preceding element passes through that point. Please note down this point as same as the preceding element passes through that point. In the figure, I draw the streamline flow diagram so you can understand easily. Okay, guys? So this is a basic definition of a streamline flow. So you can see there are three lines. There are three different paths. Let's suppose the middle one, and I have drawn three different particles or three different points on that particular flow. So now what happens in streamline flow is, now if you draw a tangent to that point, as I'm drawing, if you draw the tangent to that particular point, it gives you the direction, velocity direction to that particular point. If you draw the tangent, then it will give the direction of the flow of liquid at that particular point. Okay, and one more important thing is, two streamlines cannot cross each other. The streamline cannot cross each other. This is also a remarkable point in a streamline flow. And the tangent to any point gives the velocity direction. Okay, so this is all about streamline flow. So let's discuss one more flow, that is laminar flow. Okay, so this is also important terminology in the fluid mechanics, that is laminar flow. There are basic two type of flow, laminar and turbulent. So what happens in laminar flow? In laminar flow, if a liquid is flowing over a horizontal surface, such like that, horizontal surface with a steady flow and moves in a layer. As you can see clearly in the figure, it moves in a layer. Okay, so first thing first is the if a liquid has to be move as a steady flow, okay, it has to be steady flow and moves in a layer. First thing for laminar flow is with steady flow, and then it has to be moves in a layer. It doesn't matter if the velocities are different. It really doesn't matter if velocities are different, but it matters there has to be a layer and velocities, different layer of velocities which do not mix with each other. And in laminar flow, the particles and the velocity layers do not mix. So it's kind of a steady flow and goes on layer to layer. So they will never mix with each other. Okay. So this is the clear basic definition of a laminar flow. Okay, so you have to remember this because there might be some questions regarding this. Theoretical questions have been asked in previous exams. And the exact opposite one to the laminar is turbulent flow. Turbulent flow is kind of a mixed flow. You can say it's a kind of a mixed flow, exactly opposite to the laminar one. Okay, so what happened? When a liquid moves with a velocity greater than critical velocity, when a liquid moves with a velocity greater than its critical velocity, greater than its critical velocity, then such a motion of the particle of liquid is become disordered or irregular. Disordered or irregular. You can say it's like a zigzag motion. There are no order, there are no layers, and flow are completely mixed, irregular. So such kind of flow is a turbulent flow. So this is you can say this is the basic figure of turbulent flow. There are no layers like that, and the flow is a disorder and irregular. Okay, so this is all about. So I am drawing the basic figure for the turbulent flow so you can clearly understand. Okay, you can see very small fraction is going forward, most of the flow, most of the energy is continuously wasting inside the flow. So this is a turbulent flow. Energy is wasting, not utilizing in the forward direction. Okay, so please do remember these points about turbulent flow. It's kind of a mixed flow. Okay, so that's it about this three type of flow. Thank you.